set our collective planning priorities for upcoming years, it will allow us to work together to achieve them and importantly to manage any conflict between different authorities in that process. It will help us give the market more confidence to achieve economic growth, but also to plan better. So from an environmental sustainability point of view, it will allow us to plan better for incidents of flooding, which has been some in the process of region over recent years, but also to make sure we've got the right transport and energy infrastructure in place. And just in terms of governance, Gideon Bentoven as a mayoral advisor and chair of Nature Connected will be joining the board going forward. It's a strategic spatial framework required by the devolution agreement. So the key point here is that it does not replace the local plan processes. So Knowsley and Sefton's local plans that have been recently adopted, they have primacy, as will the St Helens and Liverpool plans that are currently in production and any other plans produced by the provincial authorities. They have primacy. This is a strategic plan that will sit above those. In terms of the process, as I say, it's a complicated process, but we've done a number of key elements already. So the strategic overview stage has been completed. The statements of cooperation on planning, which is an agreement between all authorities to work together, that has been completed. And yesterday the Metro Mayor was on a call with the Government Minister who stated there would be a need for all local authorities to have these plans in the future. Well, we've done that, we've already got that in place. And then we're underway in producing a standard evidence base. So we're required to produce that by 2018. We're well on the way in undertaking that piece of work. So although it's complicated, a lot of work has been done and we're well progressed. The final slide, just to touch on an issue that a number of members have raised with me on a number of occasions. The devolution deal requires us to have a brownfield registry in place by 2018. It is also a requirement for all individual local authorities. We are producing a brownfield list, so this is from within our existing planning frameworks, and that will be available before the back end of this year. So as a number of members have raised with me, our priority needs to be brownfield first, and we will have the list of brownfield sites before the end of the year. And then in line with the devolution agreement, we'll have the brownfield register by 2018. A key point in the register that